Hello everyone, today I, Punitika Batra, faculty of Department of BBA from Technia Institute of Advanced Studies, is going to deliver a lecture on Introduction to International Business Management. With the globalization of the world economy, there has been a continuous rise in the number of companies that operate across the globe. International business consists of trades and transactions at a global level. These include the trade of goods, services, technology, human resource, capital, or knowledge for the purpose of international production of physical goods and services such as finances, banking, insurance, and construction. What was primarily a phenomenon of Western corporations post-World War has now expanded to include companies from the East, from countries like India and China. This is the result of globalization. Globalization refers to international trade between countries, resulting in global production, global investments, global technology transfers, ultimately leading to integration of economies into one global economy. To conduct business overseas, multinational companies need to identify and merge national markets into one global marketplace. In essence, there are two major factors that underline the global trend of greater globalization. The first factor consists of eliminating barriers to make cross-border trade easier, such as free flow of goods and services, and of course the capital too. The second factor is technological change, particularly developments in communication, information processing, information technology, and of course transportation technologies too. International business is also defined as the study of the internationalization process of an organization that ultimately transforms itself into a multinational enterprise. A multinational enterprise is a company that has a worldwide approach to markets, production, or operations across various countries. Well-known multinational enterprises include fast food companies such as McDonald's, Starbucks Coffee Company, or we can talk about Microsoft, or other industrial multinational enterprise leaders, which may include vehicle manufacturers such as General Motors, Ford Motor Company, etc. Companies like Samsung, LG, and Sony are also part of the multinational culture. Multinational enterprises range from any kind of business activity or market, from consumer goods to machinery manufacture. A company can become an international company by involving in any of the goods or services. Therefore, to conduct business overseas, companies should be aware of all the factors that might affect any business activity, including but not limited to difference in legal systems, difference in political systems, difference in economic policies, the language differences, accounting standards differences, the difference in labor standards, the difference in living standards, the environmental standards, the local cultures, corporate cultures, foreign exchange market, tariffs, import and export policies, trade, trade agreements, climate, education, and many more. Each of these factors may require changes in how companies operate from one country to the other one. Each factor makes a difference and a connection. However, international business comes along with its own set of advantages and disadvantages. Let us discuss the advantages first. A country can consume those goods and services which it cannot produce. For example, the commodities produced in India can be found in USA and vice versa. This helps both the countries to enjoy those goods which they cannot produce in their own country. The second one, the productive resources of the world are utilized to the best advantage of the country. Every country expects highest return from its resources, and this leads to fall in price and better goods for consumption. The third point, heavy price fluctuations are controlled. If the price of any commodity goes up, the goods can be imported from abroad and its price can be brought down. Shortages in times of famine and scarcity can be met from imports from other countries. Countries economically backward but rich in resources may develop their industries. For example, our own country, India. Indian people are opening industries with the idea of sending produced goods to foreign countries. International business promotes peace and friendship. No country, however big it may be, can claim to be self-sufficient. It will have to depend on other countries for something or other. Free international business is essential for goodwill, peace, and to meet any requirement of the nation. Let us come to discussion of the disadvantages. First one being the worst part of foreign or international business is that it destroys the cottage or the home industries. For example, with respect to Indian industries, they need protection. If there will be no protection from the side of the government, Indian industries cannot prosper. Next, dependence on foreign business creates difficulties in the times of need. The extreme specialization which makes a country dependent on one or two industries is bad, because if at any time the industry suffers, the economic life of the people would be endangered definitely. The fourth point, countries which sell raw materials and buy manufactured goods in return are majority of the times at loss and cannot improve the country economy. The standard of living of the people cannot improve. International business under such condition leads more to discontent and unrest rather than to promote peace and goodwill. The international business may completely exhaust a country's natural resources. For example, the coal and oil, which are irreplicable. These goods are exported just for the sake of earning money and increasing profits. But the country will eventually have to suffer in the long run when their resources will be dried and exhausted completely. Imports of harmful drugs and luxury goods ruin the health of the nation. For this, people blame international business, which is not correct. International business rivalry leads to friction and war. Example of this kind is the last two world wars that we all have seen. Commercial competition often brings strained relationships between the two countries. Thus, it can be said that international business is not unmixed blessing, but to measure advantages always outweigh the disadvantages. At any rate, it is better if it is helpful in improving the economy of the country. So, I hope you all are clear with the concept of international business. Thank you.